On this episode of Smart Robots Review, we are examining the xTool D1 Pro 20-watt laser engraver and cutter. The D1 Pro is a device made for the professional and the DIY homecraft makers that can engrave and cut many flat materials, and with an optional attachment, engrave on glasses, tumblers, even jewelry. As with most of my videos, we're going to take a beginner-friendly approach to learn what it can do, get started quickly, and just have fun with it. First, we will dive right into a review of the D1 Pro features, set up the free application, and demonstrate how I laser engraved my very first test project. I'm also going to show you how to configure some of your projects via Wi-Fi to the D1 Pro, adjust the system to cut thicker materials, and walk through how you can quickly design, engrave, and cut your very own simple hanging ornaments. Finally, I will reveal what came in the box and share my step-by-step assembly experience. Are you ready? Let's roll the intro and get started.
Welcome to Smart Robots Review.
And welcome back to Smart Robots Review, the show that reviews robotics, space exploration, and fantastic tech from around and out of this world. I'm your host, Elias. So this is the xTool D1 Pro laser engraver made by Makeblock, company known for their mbot line of robotics, as well as their xTool series of laser devices. At the heart of it, of course, is this laser available in 5, 10, and 20-watt versions. I'm using the 20-watt. It boasts a top speed of 400 millimeters per second, depending on the material and what you're doing. And its movement is very precise, down to 0.01 millimeters. Except for the timing belt, the entire unit is made out of steel, down to the metal wheels. Projects can be sent to the D1 via direct USB connection or wirelessly via Wi-Fi. And speaking of projects, you can use the free xTool Creative Space application or opt for the premium option, the industry standard Lightburn software. I highly recommend protecting your workbench by placing a sheet of metal under your D1 Pro. A small 12x8-inch aluminum sheet is included with your D1 Pro for just that reason, or you can provide a different option like the 26-gauge steel sheet I purchased from my local hardware store for $30. The xTool Creative Space application is available for free from the xTool website. You can download it and get a quick start on this particular laser engraver. When getting started with the xTool Creative Space application, you may be prompted to update a couple of drivers. It's going to be really simple. You're going to get a couple of prompts, click install, and it does it for you. Next up, on the top right of the application, you're going to have a button that says Connect Device. Once you click Connect Device, it will look for your D1 Pro via the USB connection. You click it, and there you go, all connected. Now it does a quick check to see if it needs a firmware upgrade. And if it does, just follow the prompts, click update, and it will walk you through it. Firmware, by the way, is software that resides on the D1 Pro directly that allows the application to drive and control the D1 Pro. That is the update switch, and make sure it's on before saying yes to updating the firmware. A packet of different materials to try came included with my D1 Pro, and for project ideas and tutorials, visit xtool.com. And for the purpose of this test, we just need one of the pieces of wood that's included. And before we move any further, make sure you're using the protective goggles that came in the box every time you're using the printer, because lasers can be very harmful to your eyes and to your skin. All right, let's go ahead with our very first engraving project. Drag any of these shapes to the center of the workspace here, like this. If you know what material you're working with, you can use the templates, the material templates available here to the right. Or for our test here, we're gonna do a simple engrave, power set to 80%, speed to 150. Now go ahead and click process. And in this screen, we're gonna click framing. All right, so we're gonna place my 2 millimeter piece of bass wood here to the laser crosshairs. And when you click the button, it's going to frame. It's going to show you how big your engraving job is going to be approximately. So it gives you an idea how to align it and position your material. Perfect. So now the framing is completed. You click framing completed. And then click start. There we go. Now all we need to do is press the button once more on the xTool and the project kicks off. So while the test job here continues, let's see what was inside the box. Time to unbox the xTool D1 Pro Golden Red, which is the one I got. The manuals were beautifully organized, easy to understand, nice illustrations. It also came with this packet of different materials you can use. We saw this a little earlier in the video, which is great. Every piece is solid, from the metal shaft to the plates, even down to the rollers. And they're beautifully tied to protect it from shipping damage. And these are risers. This is an optional accessory, mine came with it, that allows you to elevate the xTool D1 Pro and print some bigger projects. All right, so this is the Wi-Fi antenna. Power switch, USB port, and of course the power port. Micro SD card slot right there. Overall, solid, solid, solid. Here are the belts. And this is the 20 watt diode laser. And if you're wondering what that is, think of an LED, which is a light emitting diode. This is a laser emitting diode, or an LED. Of course, LEDs are used in TVs, Blu-ray players, and all kinds of electronics, and they convert electrical current to light. This LED converts it to a laser. Protective goggles, of course you need those, and then some other accessories you're gonna need, the screws, power supply, USB cable, and the power cable. Okay, let's check back on our first engraving project, which is wrapping up, it's coming along nicely. So while it's still doing that, let's set up the Wi-Fi. In your app in the top right, there's a little gear. You click that gear, then you go into settings, enter your Wi-Fi name, your password, click complete, and bingo, you're connected. Now you can send jobs via Wi-Fi. As expected, sending jobs via Wi-Fi will not be as fast as doing so when you're connected directly via your USB cable, but certainly more convenient. And now let's check back on our project. Nice, nice and clean, no burn marks. Beautiful. Notice the tick marks on the side of the laser module. Well, adjustments to the height and focal length indicator of the laser module will need to be made depending on the thickness of the material you need to cut. The default factory laser module focal length is set to 0, and the number will need to be proportionally increased by 2 based on thickness. So, for a 6mm thick basswood, the scale needs to be set to 3, and for 8mm, it should be set to 4. But the sweet spot for what you're trying to cut may require some trial and error. So for example, and contrary to the scale in the book, what worked for me for a 2mm piece of basswood was the scale of 2. Now this is the focal length indicator they can flip down, and well, it's still too far away, gotta adjust. I do want to note that while the D1 Pro is a capable cutter able to slice through an 8mm acrylic in one pass, it is not a replacement for an industrial CNC machine. There we go. That should be... looks good. All right, let's tighten it. Let's talk about the materials that can be used with the D1 Pro. Many types of wood, including basswood, pine, birch, oak, and leather, acrylic, glass, ceramic, slate, rock, and metal. And xTool provides a guide that will help you find the optimized settings for both cutting and engraving of those materials. Now, the beautiful thing about the xTool is you can also take an image, like here I took an image. It could be a JPEG, it could be a PNG. You can engrave it and cut it all in one. All right, so let's demonstrate the capability by, how about we make our own hanging ornaments for the holiday tree or for your Christmas tree? So let's go back to the application, drag any shapes you want. The stars might be fun, so I'm picking the stars. So let's drag another shape. How about a gear? Okay, not the most holiday-like shape, but we'll use it to demonstrate something later. All right, let's draw some circle shapes, shall we? So we're gonna create some circle shapes. We're actually drawing these shapes. Hold down the left mouse button and drag. And this is where this thread is gonna go through. We're gonna use the laser to cut a hole. Now you can right click on the circle shape we just drew and say copy and then paste, or do hold down control and press C and then control and press V. That way you can copy and paste the shape identically three times. There we go. We're gonna select the circle that we put in there and we're gonna do cut. Let's increase the power to, let's say, 70 and then speed at 16. All right, we want to cut the gear as well, same thing. Now I'm using a 2mm basswood for my test. All right, so we're gonna do the same thing here, copy these settings. There we go. Okay, very nice. But I'm not sure if I like the gear, so let's just delete it and drag another shape. How about there's another star down there. It is. That's much better. There we go. Okay. All right, it doesn't get any simpler than that. So while we're finishing up this project and we're going to start cutting, let's talk about the D1 Pro, my impressions, and what I recommend. So the D1 Pro comes in the 10-watt and 20-watt versions. The 10 is around $600, the 20 is about $1,000. And then there's accessories you can get, like an enclosure, like an air assist unit that will help you get cleaner cuts. Like, see over here, there's a slight burn mark there. Even though it's a nice, clean, sharp cut, there's a slight burn mark there on the sides. Now you can adjust and optimize your print by making sure you have the right height, which I probably didn't on this particular print. And also you can use the air assist. So you're seeing here the xTool enclosure. It's great for you to contain any odors, any harmful particles, any dust that may spread around your workspace. I'm using that in conjunction with the xTool air purifier. Here's a look, an infrared look of the xTool from inside the enclosure. But we're gonna talk about that in the next episode, and how to optimize your prints. And also we're gonna look at the rotary attachment that helps you engrave on cylindrical objects. But overall, I love it. The xTool D1 Pro, go get it at $600. It's a steal, quality, comes with free software. What else can you ask for? I also recommend checking out other reviews. There are a lot of great videos out there. Go to the xTool website, browse their different pages. They have free project ideas. They have a lot of good information that can help you make an informed decision whether you're gonna decide to purchase this xTool D1 Pro laser engraver and cutter. As far as the installation goes, it took me about 40-45 minutes to assemble. I did take my time. I did use a pretty good video that I found on the xTool website that helped guide me through the installation. I used that in conjunction with the instruction manual, which is clear and I thought easy to understand. And my final tip here is take your time assembling the unit. I think if you follow the instructions to the T and watch the videos, you'll have a quick start and you'll be engraving and cutting your projects in no time. And with that, I want to thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it and found it useful, please click thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe if you haven't done so already. This is your host, Elias, and until next time, thank you for watching.